Hi guys, how are we doing so far? I figure everything is cool. In this video, I will install and configure pFsense 2.4.5 on Windows 10 Hyper-V and then configure the client side of shared key site-to-site OpenVPN. Once configured, we will test it by accessing Windows Server, WinServe 2016 S3, using Remote Desktop, Ping, and Traceroute. There are four main settings you need to do to set up site-to-site OpenVPN client. Number one, configure the client for server remote access. Number two, install the shared key created by the server. Number three, create a rule to allow anyone access on OpenVPN. Number four, configure and enable the OPT interface. So let's get going. Now let's create pFsense 2.4.5 virtual machine on a Windows Hyper-V as shown. Virtual machine name should be pFsense 2.4.5. Accept all the defaults. And take note, I've created two virtual switches called WAN and LAN. WAN connects to the outside networks and LAN connect to our internal network. So now, connect the first network card to the virtual WAN switch, then add another network card and connect it to the virtual LAN switch as shown. Set the DVD drive to image file and then select the pFsense installation ISO image. Boot up, click on Start and Connect. Accept all the defaults as prompted. We'll be right back. configure pFsense interfaces as shown. Log in as an admin using a browser and continue with the configuration of pFsense 2.4.5 as shown. We'll be right back. add internet underscore gateway IP address 192.168.1.1. Add also plaza underscore WAN underscore gateway IP address 192.168.1.21. Edit WAN interface as shown. Set IPv6 configuration type to none. IPv4 upstream gateway to internet underscore gateway as shown. under firewall, WAN rules, disable, block private embargo networks, as shown. Disable or delete IPv6 under LAN rules. At the dashboard, add widgets as required. Now, we will configure the client side of our shared key site-to-site OpenVPN as shown. Server mode, select peer-to-peer shared key. Server host or address, 192.168.1.11. Shared key, uncheck automatically generate a shared key, and paste in the shared key generated by the server previously. Description, company site, vmwp15.com. Tunnel network, 192.168.100.0/30. remote network 192.10.0/24. Click Save, and then add a rule to OpenVPN to pass any traffic from the server-side LAN to the client-side LAN as shown. Set protocol to any, and in the description, allow all on OpenVPN. Click Save, and then click Apply Changes. Now, configure the OPT1 interface as shown. There was an issue retrieving support information, for it was taking a while, and also my internet gateway was offline. I know that my wireless router is up because I was able to ping the internet gateway. I just waited until retrieving support information was finished. Sure enough, my internet gateway came online after it was done. Now we will perform our remote desktop testing. This screen will show what happened when a remote user accesses your desktop. Watch the change in OPT1 waveform, followed by getting logged out from the server. Now I will leave you with the result of our final test accessing Windows Server WinServe 2016 S3 using Remote Desktop, Ping, and Traceroute. Then I'll see you guys on my next project.